Welcome back to school, guys. Back to school reactions here. And I pulled up on this, and I don't know, I don't think this is a song. I think it's something else. Well, it may be a song, we'll see. But it says dreams do come true, and it's Upchurch. And I'm curious about this. If it's a song, okay, that's different. I think it may be something about kind of talking about, like, you know, his journey through music. Sorry. And so I'm really curious about this. I know that they dropped something not too long ago about the Mohican that's supposed to be coming out in 2020. I'm excited about that. So I'm just real curious what this is. So join me on my journey as I discover more about Upchurch. Maybe you've already seen this. If you're Creek Squad, you probably have. But maybe you haven't, and it's your first time like mine. So let's jump into this and find out what he talks about in Dreams Do Come True, okay? Okay, there we go.
You know, growing up in a small town and skipping school to go see your favorite country artist because he's throwing a free show on Broadway. This is the kind of stuff I think about when I see videos like this, because like when you're that kid riding around town bumping these artists and riding around in your truck with nothing to do, and it crosses through your head, man, what would it be like to be able to be a country singer or entertainer in general, and to be on a stage with the same people that you grew up listening to over the years, or the same people singing the same song that ran through your truck speakers a bunch of times. And
oh wow,
when you are that
nice
dude
venue. And
those thoughts did run through your head as a kid running around a small town, and then when you walk on a stage in front of 20,000-30,000 people and you see yourself on the screen 50 foot tall, and You see your freaking face beside Pepsi and all kind of other stuff, it's just kind of like, wow, like what I thought about 10 years ago actually came true. And just to sit here and watch these videos of,
wow,
you know, all these people giving their time and, you know, looking your way and listening to what you're saying and
that's
stuff.
That's a big
it's
crowd.
Like, you are
that's a good
one of those guys
show.
Now. You are one of those guys that the kids run around town jamming your stuff, thinking the same thing about you that you thought 10 years ago.
That's already happening. That's already happening. Oh my God! I reacted to some stuff from T-Rev, and you can hear it in him. He thanks Upchurch for helping him to become an artist, and because he motivated him and made him realize he could do it too. And there's other artists who've shouted out Upchurch. This is pretty cool.
About the guy who's gonna come on stage next after you, and it's a crazy, crazy feeling. It's wild watching this stuff. It's all kind of things. It's a risk. It's a goal. It's a dream. It's a curse. It's a demon.
Right.
It's everything. But when you love the chaos and you love the screaming and the yelling and the loud noise and the loud music, and you're on that stage, been dreaming about that stage and being on that stage for 10 years now, when you get there, the demons don't matter. The bad stuff
yep.
doesn't matter. It's just the good stuff that matters. And
yep.
It's really surreal being, like I said, being one of those guys and getting up on that stage and being one of those guys you dream to be in. And it's the best feeling ever, dude. It's the best feeling.
I bet. Also has its downsides, but wow. His family must be so proud to see him accomplish these goals, and I'm sure he's proud too. He's worked real hard to get there. Rock the South End. I bet he rocked it harder than anybody.
Yeah.
Man, he sure has accomplished a lot in a very short life. And I am excited to see how much more he accomplishes because he is that guy. He is, I've talked about it before, and some people may not like his music. That's okay. You don't have to. It's okay. Music is subjective. But to the people that do like his music, I'm telling you, this is the kind of artist that comes along once in a lifetime, in your lifetime. Like, there were artists who were dead and gone before I ever even heard them or appreciated their music. John Lennon. I didn't know the Beatles until I got older. I didn't know John Lennon's music until I got older. And he was one of those, I mean, imagine where he could have gone with all the music he could have done in his lifetime. And this is like with Ryan Upchurch, he is one of those once in a lifetime artists. He really is doing things that most people can't do. And he's doing it very well without all of the backing of all the major labels, because he knows what would happen if he goes there. They're just going to squash his music and they're going to tell him what he can and can't release. And who wants to do that? Why not own your own music? Why not be in charge of your career? I think this guy is he's a modern day troubadour. This guy's something else, man. Really dig this. Really, really did dig this. That was super cool. All right, guys. Let me know what you thought of it. Let me know what else to react to in the comments below. As always, be healthy, be happy, be good to each other, and stay blessed, and I'll see you real soon. Peace.